everybody. So today I wanted to talk about what an engineer actually is and what types of engineering you could go into and what types of roles you could perform within those different, bodies of engineering. So let's get into it. So according to Google, an engineer is a person who designs, builds, or maintains engines, machines, or public works, but they also serve a couple more functions than just that. They also increase efficiency and decrease costs within a company. So most of the roles that you perform at a company are going to involve either decreasing cost, increasing efficiency, or designing, like Google said, a new product or process. So I want to go over the different types of engineers that you could choose to be. So the first one is chemical engineering. Basically, chemical engineers are worried about developing chemical processes and developing chemical products. So if you're good at chemistry, if you like chemistry, it's a very chemistry heavy route and you're going to be dealing with a lot of chemicals. So the second one is mechanical engineering, and this is the branch of engineering that I've decided to go into, but mechanical engineering is basically anything that has moving parts in it, a mechanical engineer is going to be involved. They work with using heat to create energy, like internal combustion engines. They also work with mechanical systems, like any type of machinery or production. They're actually the broadest engineering discipline, which is one of the reasons that I chose to go into mechanical engineering. It's very physics heavy. So if you like physics, if you like material science, there's a lot of that. So it's a good field to get into. The next one is electrical engineering. So electrical engineers obviously deal with anything electrical. They're going to work with circuits, they're going to work with signal processing, but I think the main one is electricity itself. I think a lot of electrical engineers go to work for power companies like ComEd. Next up is industrial engineering. So industrial engineers are primarily focused on processes and how to make them more efficient and more productive. So if there's a way to cut down the cost or cut down the time in which a task is performed, that's going to be the job of the industrial engineer. It's a very statistics heavy job, so they're going to be performing a lot of statistical analyses to try and figure out how to make processes as a whole more efficient. Next up, we've got civil engineering. So civil engineers are focused on designing and improving roadways, highways, bridges, and then they also kind of branch out into structural engineering, where they focus on the structural integrity of buildings and how to improve upon those. So the last one within the, sort of common engineering bodies that I have is aerospace engineering. So obviously aerospace engineering is concerned with things that fly, or things that are in the air. So you've got two branches. You've got aerospace engineering, which they design and improve upon jets and airplanes. And then you've got aeronautical engineering, which is basically focused on spaceships and satellites, things that actually leave the atmosphere of the Earth. This is a really cool engineering discipline, but in my opinion, it's also the most difficult one because it's just really hard to do. So that's all I've got as far as the more common engineering disciplines. There are some other ones like petroleum engineering, nuclear engineering, mining engineering, material science, and although those can be very lucrative and very beneficial careers to take, not many schools offer those as much as the other ones. So the really common ones you'll find are like mechanical, electrical, and probably industrial. If you want to find a school that does like ocean engineering, you're going to have to go live somewhere that where it's applicable, like Florida. Petroleum engineering is another one that I don't see a whole lot of programs for it, but those less common ones can also be really cool too.